And welcome everybody here on Twitch chats and everybody on YouTube for some Grixis Midrange. Hawkeye, I guess, wanted to get on up here. But we have a deck here that this was a donation deck. As you can see, we're playing three donation decks today. And Hawkeye's taking the camera. The point of this deck was to make a Grixis deck with four Robber the Rich, four Thief of Sanity, and Royal Scions as well. And so this is what we came up with here. And so we got kind of like an aggressive slant on Grixis. And so I'm pretty excited to try this one out. We got just a lot of pretty fun cards to play here. Hopefully Thief of Sanity takes over some games. We played Thief of Sanity yesterday in Historic, and it was awesome for us over there. Of course, there's times where, like, Robber the Rich and Thief of Sanity, your opponent just has too much stuff in play and they're not going to really be able to get through. You can then loot them away with the Royal Scions. But also, Royal Scions can help give those creatures first strike and trample so that you do get to connect with them. So you can, you know, making Robber the Rich a four-power first strike creature makes it a lot easier to attack with it and trigger than if it was just a 2-2. Kind of the same thing with Thief of Sanity. Trample over some geese that want to block it, or arboreal grazers or anything like that. So that's what our deck's about. So the question is, why do we have so many counter spells in the sideboard? And that's because there's a lot of control in the format right now after the recent bannings with the green card. So yeah, lots of control decks. And so we're going to hopefully have some ways to interact with them on the stack there. Only going one Ionize is because, you know, we have a lot of three drops here. We got the 13 three mana cards. So I didn't want a lot of three mana counters. So we got a couple of negates, but then I also wanted something that could counter, you know, could be, you know, could counter like a Fires of Invention or Wilderness Reclamation, but could also counter a creature as well. Against lower decks, we'll be able to go up to the full four Nicol Bolas Dragon Gods 2 and kind of turn into a control deck after sideboard. So like game one, we'll try like this aggressive plan, and maybe they sideboard for this aggressive plan, and then we turn into a control deck with all this extra removal, counter magic, Nicol Bolas's, things like that. So there we go. That's what our deck's all about. Let's give this a try. Oh yeah, Knight of the Ebon Legion with the Royal Scions. That's a great combination. So yeah, donation decks, what we're going to be doing is playing them through a league here. See if we can get to five wins before two losses. Let's update our deck over here. Oh, I forgot to change my avatar for this. I was supposed to use the Nicol Bolas avatar for this league. I'll have to change that after this match. Looks like control. So they're looking pretty rich over here, so we're going to try to rob them. We got some real estate. So the reason why I shocked in with the steam vents instead of just playing the island is so that I can play Bloodfell Caves next turn and still have, so I can get this tap land in play, but I could still have the Tyrant's Scorn available. Oh, well, that hurts. Because I wanted to be able to save, you know, I was going to be able to save a creature from something like that. Get out of here, Sphinx of Foresight. Hmm. So that does make them, you know, just uses one of their two spells. They get two expensive spells a turn. That makes them use another one here by bouncing it. Yeah, we're going to have to bring in these counter spells to try to counter Fires of Invention, of course. I don't think I really attack and just do two damage here, because then if they have another Cavalier of Flame, I'll die. Every single month, you can qualify for the next Mythic Championship qualifier. Every single month. If you get top 1200 in any month, then you qualify for the next one. They only do, like, four of them a year, so it's, like, 3 months at a time. So Duress is only good against, you know, like, they have all those creatures. It's kind of the problem with, like, Duress Negate, so you can just play a whole bunch of creatures. That Clarion was obviously a really big game, that game, so maybe we could Duress away one of those. This could be a great Thief of Sanity matchup. This does a good job blocking, like, Red Cavalier. You know, flash it in, block. Yeah, I mean, Scorn's basically just a bounce spell. That can be valuable, though. Compare well with, like, Thought Erasure. No, we don't. You can't really kill enchantments in Grixis. There's like Ugin's colorless or Meteor Golem. Or there's the dispersal part of Discovery Dispersal that can put it back into their hand. That's kind of about it. Well, they kept two cards on top, so they did keep this Fabled Passage on top, and we got rid of it, so hopefully that was necessary. Yeah, always have Clarion and always have Fires of Invention. It's just such a great life they live. Well, we're always mulliganing and having no counter magic or discard. I have a Jace deck. I've played Jace in a bunch of decks. Recently, we played Jace in a Dimir control deck. Which I could try to find on YouTube. This deck had a couple of Jace in there. Oh yeah, obviously my opponent's definitely playing four copies of Clarion and four copies of Fires. I mean, I have four copies of Thought Erasure. I don't see any of my Thought Erasures.
The whole of the multiverse will bend to my death.
So that's gonna kill Nicol Bolas also.
Will be painful.
But it's out of here. You know, obviously I could have tried to just play this to block, but if they get rid of my Cavalier, I die on the spot. That was close. Sultai Spectre is right there. Oh, SSJ, change avatar. I told me too late. I forgot again. I'm sorry. Sorry. haven't seen a disinformation campaign control deck in a little while. Theme of Sanity is my best card to play. Kind of feel like if we play it, my opponent's just going to have a Ritual of Soot. I hope not. Well, that's not so bad. I just need to play Dragon God this next turn. So unfortunately we got to discard the Thief.
I have a few openings for more minions, if you're interested.
Basically, get our own disinformation campaigns up and running.
You have no weakness I cannot exploit.
No, Nexus was not the strongest deck in the full standard before rotation. No, that was that's probably Field of the Dead. But also Orzhov Vampires was a big one there too. Castle Lock Twain is pretty nice here to be able to draw an extra card. I'm going to wait till like end step, you know, like so we don't have to just discard it to more disinformation campaigns and stuff. Yeah, my opponent's playing some spice here. Teferi Time Twist with Disinformation Campaign, that's pretty cool. Yeah, I mean, if we double pump Knight of the Upland Legion there, we get 6 damage on them and turn Knight into a 2-3, but I think I'd rather just have another card. I think that this match, like, this game is just going to come down to cards. And so, yeah, it was either deal 6 damage to them or draw a card. I guess I should be drawing this first. I should have drawn first.
Witness a mote of my power.
Well, that's good. That's kind of ridiculous.
I will spare you in exchange for it.
No, I wasn't killing those off. Again, we just want more cards and get rid of the cards from them. they want to like spend their entire turn to turn Lazav into a Dream Eater, like whatever. That was a really good steal.
My schemes are never.
Yeah, I liked my opponent saying hello. That's pretty good. So we have a Nicol Bolas with a card style and without a card style. Yeah, that's true. Spark Double with the new Garruk is an instant ult. They didn't even play Disinformation Campaign. They're not using that mana. They could at least like you add mana and then exile.
Let your weak minds crumble.
All right, so they'll be able to bounce the Spark Double back to their hand. Not exactly sure why they just don't do that during their turn, so I don't get to activate it. But that's okay. So playing Rankle there meant that they had to block Rankle, because if they don't block Rankle, then I just say we both sacrifice, and they have to sacrifice their Dream Eater anyway. I wanted to make sure to get their creature that was going to be, the Dream Eater could have attacked and pressured the Nicol Bolas, you know, like we're threatening ultimate over here. All right, so looks like we got the Nicol Bolas ult.
My wrath is your damnation.
All right, that was a cool game. So we're gonna have Dispute, Duress, more Nicol Bolas that just won us that game. All this counter magic. Just don't think these small creatures matter too much. Those ones. We're basically going to be a Robber of the Rich, Thief of Sanity deck. They did, you know, like steal one of our creatures, so I kind of like these Tyrant Scorns. Don't know if I need to play all these Murderous Riders. Probably don't. Maybe I'll play Paragon. I'll play Reaper. Trap activated. Transform into control. Yes, I played Historic all day yesterday. You can, if you're interested in watching Historic matches, the YouTube channel there, we played 12 hours of Historic yesterday. But yeah, I like it. I've been enjoying it so far. No, I'm a mystical dispute. So much discard. I should have shocked in with one of these. I should have shocked in with like Watery Grave instead of just playing Swamp. Probably. Okay, because I was going to say like Disinformation Campaign. I guess I would just be discarding the Steam Vents anyway over the Swamp. Because the Swamp's more valuable, but... You have a hand. What a bizarre expectation. You want to play your spells. I like it. Mission briefing. Get even more thought erasers in there. Resolve? It's the problem with discard spells, is you can't discard the top of the library.
You have no weakness I cannot exploit.
That is the weakness of discard spells. Unfortunately, our hand is just... Our hand's too rich. We don't get to rob anything.
It's a moat of my power.
But Thief of Sanity should be able to steal stuff. If we can't rob the rich, we should be able to thief some sanities. So I'm casting this right now so that my opponent has one card in hand I don't. And so now we trigger the Robber of the Rich. Those are some good games. But you can see the power of Nicol Bolas, Dragon God. Won us those. All right, we're 1-1. No land. Two land. Hmm. I like these cards that we have. I honestly don't know what to put back here. I like these cards. All right, Thrice. Take care. Thanks, Eric. Yeah, some fun historic stuff yesterday. The thing is, like, Paragon is, like, my best blocker. So that's tough. I kind of think it was, you know, Paragon or Knight. Kind of want to put back Knight. All right, we're gonna need land. Sturmheart with the Twitch Prime sub. Thank you so much there, Sturmheart. All right, get out of here, Crusader. Look like Buddy Holly. Not a bad person to look like. The sad defensive robber. Sure, Jim. Thanks so much for the Twitch Prime sub there, Cult Wolf. I appreciate that. Yeah, Robber the Blocker. It's our seventh sub of the day. It's definitely possible I didn't put in enough sideboard against aggro. We'd also just, you know, hit our land drops. That would be nice. We just brought in a couple of Legion's Ends. So we have a few things. We brought in a couple of Legion's Ends. Still haven't uploaded the Abzan adventure yet. Okay. I had to finish the upload for the Abzan adventure that we got done playing a little while ago. Robber of the Rich has reach, and it's pretty... Okay, I was going to say, it's kind of hidden, so they may have attacked into it.
I'm a god once again.
I'm going to say it's... Yeah, Robber of the Reach. Robber of the Reach.
My schemes are never ending.
That seems tiresome. Of course, I have the Black Lance Paragon that can take out this knight this next turn.
My intellect is without limit.
They didn't do a very good job tapping their mana. We should have this. All All right, I just want to exile that thing so they can't get it back with another Order of Midnight. Honestly, I just shouldn't even attack there. It doesn't matter. It's all about Nicol Bolas ultimating, but I guess it's a good attack if they have something to deal with Nicol Bolas. Okay. So now we're going to be going to game three. We got game two there. We're going to be on the draw. Just going to make our life a little more difficult. What do they have? So they have basic planes. They had Sky Knight Legionnaire. I'm just thinking, like, what do they have for to Noxious Grasp? I think all we saw was Sky Knight Legionnaire. I would assume they'd have the red-white Lord. They had a claimed contender. It's Circle of Loyalty last game. So is Noxious Grasp better than any of these other cards? As we saw there, like, Robber of the Rich is basically just a 2-mana 2-2 blocker for this matchup, which is really not very good. But, oh, they had Wintermore Commander also. Yeah, we'll take out a couple of Robbers for some Noxious Grasps. Not a great Royal Scions matchup either. All right, let's try this. Maybe I'm supposed to play Rankles instead of Royal Scions. Just be a blocker. Ugh. Yeah, I kept a couple in there, but yeah, that's true. It does block that 1-2 flyer well. But then the card we just brought in gets rid of that 1-2 flyer as well. Why can't we have blue mana? I really like turn 2 Legion's End. We don't have blue mana. Mulliganing never works. What is this nonsense? This is just nonsense. Definitely should have just kept the 7. Okay. So I think my best hope is Thief of Sanity, start hitting them and getting cards. It's not a very good hope. Of course. Wish I would have just kept the 7. Yep. If I would have kept the 7, we would have had the Legion's End for these things. For this Etrada deck, I think 4... I think Teferi's Time Twist is a cool card, but 4 is too many copies of that card. And I think you probably want, like, 24... lands or so. Not 23 seems really low, especially with playing 4 6 drops, 2 7 drops. 23 is too little land. I get more discoveries, more lands, less Time Twist, less Dream Eater. Dream Eater is cool, but 4 is just too many. Oh, okay, so it's a combo card with Etrada. Still seems like 4 is too many. Basically just have to find...
Courage is the greatest virtue.
Aye, with the knowledge to direct it.
Legion's End.
I enjoy the proper application of knowledge.
If we would've just kept the 7, now I have to go to 4. You know, like, it wasn't a great 7-card hand, of course. You know, I had just a Legion's End and 5 lands. No blue for the Thief of Sanity. You would kind of assume that, like, the 6-card hand would be, you know, a couple of lands. And the 5-card hand would maybe be a couple of lands. No, I couldn't. I mean, at that point, I was dead, even if they had Legion's End, if I tried taking with the Thief. Yeah, I do think that hand was a mulligan. No Cry of the Carnarium, because Cry doesn't really work with our deck. With our Robber of the Rich, Thief of Sanity deck. Yeah, I was just a mulligan. I think we could probably use another versatile removal spell instead of Midnight Reaper. Because I think we're going to be okay against control decks. I think the Midnight Reaper is probably overkill against, like, control decks. And maybe that versatile removal spell is just another Blacklands Paragon. I like Paragon a lot. The card's good. Yeah, I think that... that, yeah, we should just change that. Paragon just is really nice with Royal Scions. You know, you can flash in Paragon at end step. You know, this can kill a questing beast if need be, but you can also flash it at end step, make it at 5 power first, you know, play this on turn 2, roll Silence on turn 3, you have 5 power, first strike. That's a good way to race. Could be another Dragonfire, Tyrant Scorn, or Legion's End in the main. But Paragon's, like, good against aggro and just good against, you know, this can block Rotting, you know, this can kill Rotting Regisaur. So this is good against aggro. That's also just kind of, that's a good card against control because it's also a flash creature against control. So I like Paragon a lot. yeah, the Derby Hat Knight avatar. Oh, man, SSJ, I'm so sorry about not ever switching that avatar. I just never went back and thought about that again. But we saw, like, Robber of the Rich. It was never really that good for us. 2-2 body is just so small. Unfortunately, it just wasn't too good. I really like this card in Historic with Burning Tree Emissary. I think this card pairs amazingly with Burning Tree Emissary, where you can get some free 2-2s. Like, you know, play Burning Tree Emissary, get a free 2-2, then play Robber, where then they don't have... then you have one less card in your hand, because, you know, you just played a card off Burning Tree Emissary, so you have one less card in your hand, which is good for the Robber. Then you also, you know, have more creatures out and everything. But... but yeah, maybe if I would have just kept that 7. The Legion's End, you know, my opponent mulled a 5. Maybe if I would have just kept the 7, yeah, maybe we draw a blue mana and we can get there. But it just didn't happen there. Knight of the Ebon Legion didn't look spectacular with our deck, because we just didn't make our opponent lose enough life to, like, really gain it, to really grow it. And honestly, that's actually probably the card that was the most disappointing, was Knight of the Ebon Legion, because we never really grew it, and we just didn't have time to activate it because we were just doing other stuff with our mana all the time. So maybe that's the thing. Maybe I need to get rid of the Robbers and just have, or sorry, get rid of the Knight of the Ebon Legions and have more interaction. And because this card honestly was, yeah, that. Because this was just basically a 1-2 the whole time. It's just a 1-mana 1-2. Which, that's not a good card. I don't know exactly what to put in there, like, where that would go. And plus, like, our mana base kind of tough, like, where we have to, like, have a whole lot of tap lands and everything. So this, we just kind of fill this in, like, whenever we can. It's not really, like, the best turn 1 play, because it's really hard to play it on turn 1 with our mana base. No, I think I like Scorching Dragonfire more than Lava Coil. It's basically just like Questing Beast for, like, that extra point of damage. There's not a lot for the extra point of damage, but being able to be instant speed, you know, against flash decks or anything. I really like the instant speed. And I also really like being able to do damage to Planeswalkers, because now we see a lot more Narset and Teferi, and being able to kill Narset and Teferi is really nice, where Lava Coil doesn't do that. Yeah, I could just play, like, Bone Crushers. It's just more 2s and 3s, but yeah, I could just play more Bone Crushers instead of Knights. Kind of wish we had, like, another good, like, 4 or 5 mana card. Could just be, like, a couple Bone Crusher and a couple Duress, like, main deck. I don't know, maybe, like, Drown in the Lock. Basically, like, Duress to try to help protect, you know, like, Robber, Thief, stuff like that. Could be a couple Negates, you know, maybe just get, like, some main deck counter magic, like, a couple Negates, stuff like that. I don't know, those are all options to think about. There's so many cards that you can play, so finding, like, the exact right cards to play is kind of tough. I think I'd rather play Duress than Drill Bit. I think Drill Bit would cost 3 mana too often. You can't really, like, drill bit to and then play Thief of Sanity kind of thing. A lot of options here. A lot of options with this kind of deck. It's a tough one to kind of crack. All right, but that's it here for Grixis Midrange. So if you're watching on YouTube, you know, hit that like and subscribe buttons over there. And also, let me know what you think about, like, some of the different card choices. Like, how would you build it? If you know you wanted to play Robber the Rich, Thief of Sanity, Royal Scions, how do you make that work? That was my challenge here. Overall, I liked our deck overall. But yeah, we had a couple of cards that didn't perform too well. And I think that maybe taking out Knight of the Ebon Legion is, like, the thing to do, is to try to find something else there. All right, but that's it here for Grixis Midrange. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.